Hello, I'm back in my own space and I finally have an intro. Here it is. Last week on 17th of January, I hit a year with my orange lenses for visual snow syndrome. I have been meaning to do a video about my orange lenses for visual snow syndrome for so long. I wanted to do one at 3 months, I wanted to do one at 6 months, I considered doing one at 9 months, and then I just thought, well, let's just do the year. And I still missed it, but better late than never, I guess. So I've now been wearing my orange lenses for visual snow syndrome for a whole year and a couple of days, and I've had lots of questions since I got them, and I'm finally here to answer them. I did a poll on my Instagram asking for questions, and these are the most common ones I had. I did ask for questions that were not, do they help? Because that is the question I get asked the most, so I'm going to answer that now. Do they help? Yes. Yes, they do. They do help some symptoms of visual snow syndrome. How do they help? They help me not have as many headaches, they help me not have glare, and they help me just to be able to see a little bit more. Which kind of leads on to the next question of, what do they help with? Some might argue that's the same question, whatever. They help specifically with light sensitivity, so they do not do anything for the visual snow or the static that you see. I don't know why they would, they don't. All they do is they filter light coming in and they take the edge off of light sensitivity. They have less light coming in, and less light coming in is less pain. So these have helped massively with light sensitivity, and they kind of help with the after images as well, because the after images are when light comes in and it makes like an imprint on the retina. I'm not really sure the exact science of that. I might do a video on it, I might not. But basically, if there's less light coming in, there's less contrast and there's less likely to have an after image, or it's a weaker after image, but it's not for every after image, if that makes sense. It kind of lessens them a little bit, not loads, but it really helps. Every little helps. It does kind of help with reading as well, because I would get after images of the lines if it was like remotely bright. It hasn't fixed it, but it's lessened it. I think with more of a tint, it would help more, but I don't want to have too much of a tint, because then it's basically sunglasses, which I also have. They have more of a blue tint, not really sure why, just the color that they came in, and they help more with light sensitivity than these, but it's not feasible for me to wear them every day. I don't need to wear them every day. This is fine for like 80% of my day. So to clarify, I still have the other symptoms of visual snow syndrome, being the double vision, the visual snow itself, blue field entopic phenomenon, but that has never really bothered me anyway, that's just like bonus sky sprites to me. And poor night vision, these actually kind of make it worse. I still have my clear lenses. I'm not in the habit of swapping them in and out. I'm just not. I just suck at seeing at night. People who don't know me ask me what my glasses are for. So I wear mine for visual snow syndrome. I think I've said visual snow syndrome so much and not really talked about it. So if you want to know more, I'll put a card up here to what is visual snow syndrome, and it runs through the diagnostic criteria and everything. Mine are for visual snow syndrome, but there are many other reasons why people will wear tinted lenses. Any condition that gives you light sensitivity might benefit from tinted lenses. Plenty of people on the visually impaired and blindness spectrum who suffer with light sensitivity will wear sunglasses a lot. One of the most common questions I see asked to the blind community is, why do you wear sunglasses if you are blind? And light sensitivity is the answer. People with Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, I-R-L-E-N, might wear tinted lenses to help them process words, numbers, and different stuff that they see. I don't have Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. Go find somebody that does if you want to know more about that, but tinted lenses might help there. People with migraines often wear tinted lenses to filter out the triggering wavelengths of light frequently blue light, and they use the FL71 rosy tinted lens a lot. I have no experience in that, so can't vouch for it. Orange lenses specifically, and red ones as well, are often used to filter out blue light. Now, blue light gets attributed to a lot of problems. If you are staring at computer screens all day, you are more exposed to blue light, and blue light can sometimes cause issues with sleeping. It can cause more eye strain, and wearing a tinted lens might be able to help you avoid some of that, but I don't believe that blue light specifically causes all the world's ills, like a lot of people say it does. But a lot of people do wear the glasses to remove the blue light anyway, and that's fine. And people with dyslexia, if they use a dyslexia tint or like a filter over paper or different coloured paper, they might also benefit from having that on a lens, so they don't have to put the filter over everything that they read, they just see it. And that is not an exhaustive list. Many people wear tinted lenses for many, many reasons. Some people just wear it for fashion, and I'm totally here for that because it normalises it. Another really common question I get asked is, where did you get them? I got mine from Specsavers because mine are prescription lenses because I have visual acuity issues as well. So I am long-sighted, I need these to read, and I'm constantly reading stuff. So I needed them to have a prescription, and I have astigmatism as well, and it's got the thing in there for that. Don't know what it is. Not that clued up on my eye health outside of visual snow syndrome. So I had to get mine from Specsavers because I needed it to be a prescription lens. You can get non-prescription lenses just from Amazon, eBay, costume shops. They are so readily available. Most opticians, most places you can get prescription lenses, will also be able to offer you a tinted lens if you ask, especially if that optician gives you sunglasses too. Over-the-counter non-prescription lenses are much, much cheaper than prescription lenses, so I will do a cost breakdown for you now because they were expensive. Very privileged to have had help being able to afford these so that I can live my life and be in a bit less pain. So my cost breakdown is, I got the frames for £69, and they're quite nice frames, quite like them. And it was on their 2-for-1 deal, so it's £69 and you get two sets of frames. So I got these, and I got prescription sunglasses so I could read outside specifically. Then the tint and the UV filter, because they don't allow you to get a tint without getting a UV filter, because when you have a tint, it makes your eyes dilate a little bit to compensate for the lack of light coming in. And then it puts you more at risk for UV damage inside the eye, so when you have a tint, you have to have the UV. And that cost me £30, and that was for the sunglasses as well, so I did that twice. So that was £60. And then the eye test, I think I paid about £30, and because it was when I got my visual snow syndrome diagnosed, I had to do the enhanced one that has a bit more to it. They assessed my peripheral vision and they did like a scan of the back of my eye to test for all sorts of things that could be causing my visual snow syndrome symptoms, to rule it out. And then there was the cost of the lenses, which I can't remember what they were, and I can't remember if I got an anti-scratch coating, but my total bill was about £240 something, I think. Hello, Editing Max here, with my warm toned light bulb. I just went through my bank statements from last year and checked. It was £163, not £240. Not quite sure where I got £240 from. But yeah, £163 with everything I just mentioned. Which is why I suggest, if you're thinking of tinted lenses and you need a prescription, buy some of the cheap non-prescription ones first. Figure out what level of tint helps you and find out if it helps you, and then go to your optician and say, hey, I've researched this, this is a thing that I have. Tinted lenses are helpful to me, but I have prescription lenses, so obviously they're not helpful right now, etc., etc., can you sort me out? And then it's not spending money trying to figure out whether they work or not, or it's not, if they don't work, you haven't spent a lot of money figuring that out, if that makes sense. Next question, what's the difference with and without them? So with them, I will show you in a minute, but with them, the depth of colour is just better. I can tell colours apart much better. Like, very similar shades of the same colour, I can pick it out. I found this out on an Instagram story the other day. There's an Instagram filter going around where it's like a colour test and you gotta pick the odd one out. I was so much better with my orange lenses than I was without. And everything, it's kind of golden hour every hour, but there's not really that much difference because, kind of like cameras, your brain is very good at bringing things back to normal. So when I put them on immediately, it's quite orange, but within a matter of seconds, everything's normal again. Like, I look at white and I see white. It is a warm toned white, but it's still white. When I take them off, everything is blue and cool toned until I adjust, and it kind of hurts more. It's a bit harsher, like everything, it doesn't blur any lines, but things just look harsher. And it depends on the lighting that I've taken them off in as well. Like, at night time, it's probably not so much of a big deal. But it's, without them, it's just harder to see and more painful to see. So it's just less painful. Whether it looks different or not, it just hurts less, which is very, very nice. Everything just looks really normal, I promise. The next question is, do they change how you perceive colours? And I think I accidentally just answered that. But the only thing the colour difference really impacts is when I'm editing photos or trying to colour balance my videos, which I just don't really bother with unless it's especially dark, then I just up the brightness. But with these on, I can't get an accurate brightness because it makes everything a bit darker, so I have to take them off to do that. And I have to take them off to edit my Instagram photos, otherwise they look very strange. And it's also given me this really weird new trick, I guess. It's really pointless and I don't care, there's no judgement here, but I can tell if somebody has had their teeth whitened. And like, normal teeth, teeth that haven't been whitened, they do not look yellow. It doesn't make everyone's teeth look yellow, it really doesn't. They look natural, but when you've had your teeth whitened and then you look through an orange lens, it looks more unnatural and I can tell. But that's it. That's the only thing I've noticed. Someone asked me, how do they work? Give me the science. I don't really have a lot of the science, but I can tell you that just the tint blocks out certain wavelengths of light. Just like sunglasses, they just block out light, so less is getting into your eye to cause you pain. So when you're light sensitive, a normal amount of light coming in registers as more light, and it can be painful, like it is with me. So having a tint, you get less light coming in, and it's less painful, you're registering it as less light. You're actually registering it as a normal amount of light, even though it's less, because you register a normal amount as too much, if that makes sense. They're exactly like sunglasses, but the tint is a lot less. And the rest is just colour theory, so having a warmer tint of lens, so if you've got the pinky ones, red ones, orange ones, they will filter out blues, greens and violets, and vice versa. If you have blues, greens and violet glasses, you'll have a much cooler tone experience than wearing an orange lens. Another question I had, especially when I started, it wasn't really a question, people were just telling me, if I wear a tint, it will make my light sensitivity worse. And to a degree that might be true, but only if you go straight to the extreme end and you wear them 24/7. So if you have mild light sensitivity or none at all and you wear sunglasses all day, every day, when you take them off, there's going to be so much more light coming in, your eyes and your brain is going to need a moment or two to adjust. And that's why people perceive that wearing a tint will make your light sensitivity worse. If you do it long term, to an extreme, then it might take longer for your eyes and your brain to register normally. So if you have mild sensitivity, choose a mild tint and it will just help you get through your day in a less painful way or a less taxing way, rather than, oh, I have light sensitivity, I'm gonna wear Polaroid sunglasses every single day. Just be sensible and it won't make your light sensitivity worse. I checked with my optician and that's what he said. The next question I get asked is, do you have to care for them differently? And no, not really. The tint is like bonded on. They are made in a lab. I believe they are clear lenses dipped in a tint, which then bonds to the lens, and it's all, you can't take it off at home. It's one of those things where outside of a lab you just can't do it. You could probably scratch it off, but they're glasses, so why would you? There's been no care difference. I just clean the lenses because it helps me just see better as normal glasses, but you can't clean the tint off unless you somehow find the chemicals that they use to remove it in labs. But I don't even think they remove it in labs, I think they just give you a new lens. Not really sure how it works, but the care is the same. Do I recommend them for visual snow syndrome? Yes, absolutely. I recommend that you try out over-the-counter tints first, because not everyone is as lucky as me in the sense that you find one that works first time. If I had to go back and it was free to do, I would probably get ever so slightly more of a tint and perhaps a different lens shape, because I do have a lot of space around here where non-tinted light comes through. I should have tried on sunglasses to find the right frames rather than clear lenses to figure that one out, but it's not the end of the world. Just you can make a very expensive mistake, so try the cheap ones first, find out roughly what you want, and then it will not be a disaster. Mine is not a disaster, that's not what I'm saying, but it could have so easily been so much worse. It could have been a nightmare if I hadn't got it so right the first time. I only recommend these if you are suffering with light sensitivity from visual snow syndrome or another condition. I don't recommend it if you have visual snow syndrome without the light sensitivity part, because they don't help the other symptoms. The after images a little bit, because you've got less light coming in and less of an imprint made on your eye to give an after image, but that kind of goes hand in hand with light sensitivity. It's just not a cure for the other visual snow syndrome symptoms, so don't expect it to be. It's only really good for a subset of the symptoms. Will I keep wearing them? Yes. I have no reason to not wear them. I think they are very helpful. They give me... I used to get so many more headaches than I do. So I have so many different types of headaches that I get. Eye strain headaches happen less. I get less tension headaches from like squinting at computers that are just too bright. Yes, you can turn the brightness down. No, I didn't do that. And like reading is so much easier now. I can read in different light situations and not struggle with seeing the lines. If you know, you know. And also I still have my clear lenses, so it's not the end of the world if I don't wear them, but what I need to start doing more of is actually putting my sunglasses on when I go outside and in brighter situations. It's just, I haven't built the habit yet. When I was a kid, I used to, for some reason, not want to wear sunglasses, and it's really stuck. So I have these sunglasses which will help my sensitivity outside, and I just don't, for some reason. So I just need to get in the habit of switching glasses when things get too bright. Even my bedroom sometimes, like I have to sit and wait for the sun to move. I can just put my sunglasses on in my bedroom to do stuff. Not film with my sunglasses on, because you've seen what happens to my face when the light hits it. But just doing other stuff. If I'm noticing it's really bright in here, I should just put my sunglasses on. That would make more sense. So that's something I need to work on. But yes, I will still be wearing tinted lenses. Maybe I'll experiment with some more, but it's expensive to have it prescription, so there's that. So that is all the questions that I got about my tinted lenses for visual snow syndrome. If I have missed any, put them down in the comments and I'll make a second video like this. And while you're there, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already for more visual snow syndrome content. Trying really hard to balance all of the topics I talk about. Don't think I'm doing very well, but I'm having fun. And ring that notification bell so you get notified every single time I post a new video. Videos go up every Saturday at 6 p.m. UK time with at least one bonus video every single month. See you!